Cheese Cool Jack's a part of the band, and my Monster Mash is the hit of the land. For you, the living, this mash was meant to. When you get to my door, tell them Bordy sent you.
Then you can mash.
Then you can Monster Mash.
The Monster Mash.
And do my graveyard smash.
That's all request done and dusted. Thanks for another fabulous week of tea time. Thanks for just being fantastic. On the way next, Michelle Visage. I'll see you Monday from 5. This is Radio 2 on the BBC Sounds app, on your smart speaker and on 88 to 91 FM.
BBC News at 7 o'clock. This is Nikki Cardwell. Vladimir Putin has told crowds at a patriotic pop concert that Russia will achieve victory against Ukraine. The event at Moscow's Red Square was held after the president announced that he was formally seizing large parts of Russian-occupied Ukraine. Mr. Putin led cheers for the four annexed territories, which has been dismissed as a sham by the international community. Lord Ricketts is the former head of the UK's Foreign Office. He says this should not be seen as a show of strength by the Kremlin.
This is a demonstration of weakness by Putin, really. I mean, he's weak on the battlefield, he's losing territory. He showed weakness at home as well with this huge popular resistance to his mobilization call. And I think he's trying to change the subject, and he's trying desperately to find something that he can present as a success.
President Zelensky has vowed to recapture the territories. The UK and the US have issued a fresh round of sanctions against Moscow. The NATO General Secretary, Jens Stoltenberg, said it would support Ukraine to reverse what he called an illegal land grab. Volodymyr Zelensky says he's now applied for fast-track membership to the alliance.
De facto, we have already completed our path to NATO. De facto, we have already proven interoperability with the alliance's standards. They are real for Ukraine, real on the battlefield, and in all aspects of our interaction. We trust each other, we help each other, and we protect each other. This is what the alliance is. Today, Ukraine is applying to make it de jure.
The House of Lords is to consider a change to the online safety bill to help bereaved parents access information about social media companies. Lady Kidron has said that she'll table an amendment to the legislation, which is going through Parliament, after a coroner concluded that content viewed on social media had contributed to the death of the teenager Molly Russell, who killed herself in 2017. On the eastern coast of the United States, Hurricane Ian is hurtling towards the Carolinas from Florida. Winds and rain are starting to hit the South Carolina coast, and there are warnings of life-threatening storm surges. Officials say Ian may have already killed 21 people. The BBC's Neda Torfik is in the town of Fort Myers in Florida.
Authorities are still focused on the search and rescue efforts not far from here. One gentleman was just recently pulled out of the rubble alive under a restaurant. So that is still the focus. Authorities say that they hope the fatalities don't rise. But still, this is going to be a years-long recovery effort.
And Steve Wright signed off from his final daily BBC Radio 2 programme after 23 years. He thanked listeners in a heartfelt speech during the last edition of Steve Wright in the Afternoon. Scott Mills takes over later this year. And the weather, scattered blustery showers, particularly in northern western parts of the UK. BBC News, it's 3 minutes past seven.
Radio 2.
BBC Radio 2!
Michelle Visage.
Mama's here!